DBN Nation, of course. Support DBN Nation. You're hearing it from Floyd Money Mayweather. What's going on?
This is Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder, and you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation.
It's Terrence Crawford, and you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation.
Man, shout out to Dante's Boxing Nation.
My name is Gennady Golovkin.
And you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation.
This is AK reporting, and you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation. Go ahead and visit AskKickIt.com. And while you're at it, subscribe below. But before we get straight to it, I just want to make one thing clear. You're going to hear me report on Dante's Boxing Nation every now and then due to the fact that it's hard for one person to keep up with all the news that's in boxing. Plus, Dante has other channels that he's working on as well. So that being said, y'all can also show love to Dante's Cooking Nation and Dante's Travel Nation. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, that'd be on the description box below. But let's get straight to it. So David Benavidez got busted by VADA using a banned substance. At first, I thought it was PEDs, such as steroids, etc., etc. However, it turned out to be cocaine. Now, as far as I'm concerned, I could care less as long as it ain't a substance that's gonna enhance your ability to fight and affect your opponent. So him taking cocaine really don't bother me because it's not gonna affect his opponent. It's only affecting David Benavidez himself, his health, and the bright future that he has ahead of him, because he's only damaging his health. Now, if he's taking it right before the fight, we have an issue, because he's gonna be walking through anything and everything. You're gonna have to hit him with everything in the kitchen but the kitchen sink, and he still won't go down. You're gonna need a gun to put him down. So as long as he's not taking it right before the fight, if he's taking it during camp, before camp, that's his problem. Because he's affecting himself, like I said. He's not affecting or harming his opponent, which is Darrell. He was supposed to fight Darrell for the vacant belt, but then Darrell had an injury. Now he's supposed to fight Darrell again. So I don't know if this is going to affect the fight, because if he gets suspended, then they're going to have to postpone the fight. However, on the article I read on Boxing Scene, it says most likely he won't get suspended, even though that's kind of odd, because they suspended Tyson Fury when he got busted for cocaine leading up to the Klitschko rematch. But who knows? Only time will tell. Now, as far as David Benavidez goes, he should take this as a life lesson, because when you listen to these rappers, musicians, entertainers talking about drugs, they don't even be taking half of these drugs they be talking about in their music, because they just be using it for promotion to sell music to these drug addicts. And if you're a fighter, you're not supposed to be smoking hookah, drinking, let alone taking drugs like cocaine. Because, like I said, talent is cool, but hard work beat talent when talent don't work that hard. And David Benavidez have all the talent in the world, but you let it go to waste by doing stuff like that. So you gotta be dedicated to the sport. And Floyd is a perfect example, because Floyd Mayweather, when he was 30 plus, he was already a millionaire. Not even a millionaire, he was almost half a billionaire. So he had all the money in the world, all the fame in the world, big mansions, wakes up to a massage, jacuzzi, all you could think of. But when it comes to fight time, he gets up, works out 12 hours a day. He works out like he has nothing. He works out like he's broke. And that's why he always preaches hard work and dedication, because that's what you gotta do if you want to stay on top. It's hard to be a champion, but it's even harder to maintain as a champion. And that's why Floyd Mayweather is one of the all-time greats, because of his hard work and dedication. Not even his talent alone. No, on top of that is his hard work and dedication. So at the end of the day, David Benavidez, like I said, should take that as a life lesson, because it's better to make the mistake when you 20 than make the same mistake when you 30. Because when, let's say he got caught when he's 30 years old, he probably already messed up his career. He probably already too addicted to quit. So it's a good thing that he got caught sooner than later. And David Benavidez already came out and apologized to the public, to the fans, and to the WBC, and to all the people that he let down, which is a good thing that he's standing up to it. Because I remember watching his brother turn pro for the first time. I've been following his career ever since. And I remember David Benavidez, he was overweight, and he was talking about dropping down in weight all the way to light heavyweight, etc., etc., and he actually made it happen, and he became a champion. So a lot of people look up to him. So David Benavidez should know better than making mistakes like this and, you know, be on cocaine or using cocaine either for, depressing reasons, having fun, whatever the case might be. Because a lot of kids look up to you. Now think about it. People that look up to you end up making the same mistakes you did because they like, hey, even the guy I look up to did that or made that mistake. So you always got to keep that in mind. And also, David Benavidez is a humble champion. He showed love to Dante Boxing Nation, came on the radio show. So shout out to David Benavidez and his whole family. Like I said, he has no reason to be doing cocaine or any of that because, first of all, he's a fighter. He got to live the fighter lifestyle. And on top of that, he got a bright future ahead of him. He got a beautiful family. And he got everything that he could ask for. So that's why people need to stay away from drugs, period, fighters or not. And like I always say, if you're trying to get smarter by the minute, subscribe below. If you're trying to get dumber by the second, don't listen to these casual ass fans. And peace.